Welcome to the Kommunicate Android SDK integration and push notification setup tutorial. Without any delay, let's get started.
Today we will set up Kommunicate Chat SDK locally in our Android app. I have already created one sample app that just contains a single activity with a floating action button on the bottom right. You can see here, and our aim is to launch the Chat SDK on clicking on this button. To get all these dependencies, we will go to the documentation. So let's go to the website. And here on the resources tab, you could follow the docs. Select Android as the platform. And now in the installation section, we have all the steps written. Since our Gradle is above 6.8, we will use this piece of code and add this into our settings.gradle. Also add this implementation in module build.gradle. After that, sync the project, and we could also add the permissions accordingly. Add these permissions over here in the manifest file. Now our Gradle is finished. We will follow to the next step in the documentation. Let's go to the authentication. And now here we have to provide the app ID to launch the SDK. So we will head over to the dashboard to get the app ID. Now in the dashboard, head over to the settings tab, and in the install section, you get the app ID. So copy that and initialize your SDK using this piece of code. Let's go to the main activity and initialize it on the top. Here we need to pass the context and application key. So for context, let's pass the application context and the application key from the dashboard. After that, we need to open the conversation using this piece of code. So let's create a helper function. And inside this function, let's copy this piece of code. For the context, we take a context in the function and pass this. Now we have these two functions, on success and on failure. So if you have a success, you could just launch the conversation. So to do that, let's just write communicate.openConversation and pass the context. And if it's a fail, let's just write a simple toast message. Okay, now we need to call this open conversation from the onClick method of this floating action button. So let's call it from here and pass the context. Since we do not have this context here, so we take the context from the signature and pass the context from here. Okay, now we can check our app again and see if the chat conversation is opening or not. We have an error here called as duplicate class found. So we have this error solved in this troubleshooting section. And we need to add this piece of code in the gradle.properties. So we go to this here and add this. Let's sync again. And launch the app again. Okay, now our app is launched. Let's click on this button to see if the chat is loading or not. Now we could see that the chat is loaded, and let's initiate a conversation and chat from here. Now we could also cross-check this message in our dashboard. So head over to the dashboard. And you could see that we received a message. You can also reply from here. And see that we received the message in the mobile site. Okay, now let's also try to implement this FCM token in our app so that whenever we get a message and our app is closed, then we receive a notification on the top for a new message. So to do that, let's also follow this documentation. In the push notification section, we have all the steps written. So first of all, we have to make a project. Let's create a new project and call it as support room and continue. We could select default account. Let's see the next step. Till then it is building. So after that, we should go to the project settings and enable a server key that needs to be given in the Kommunicate dashboard. Okay, now it is finished. Just continue. And we need to register an Android app in this project. So let's click on Android. Here we need to define a package name. So we could get a package name from here, from the main activity. Let's copy this, paste it over here. Let's call it as support room application. Register the app now. And then we are provided with a Google services.json. We need to add this in our app directory. So for that, let's change our view to project. And we need to add this inside this app file, app folder. So let's click on download. And add it inside it. Also rename it to Google Services. Okay, after that, we need to add all the dependencies required. So first of all, we need to add this in our root level Gradle files. So change the view again and add it inside the root level. Then we need to add this in module level. So let's copy this. And we need to add this one also. After that, let's continue on the console and sync now. Then let's go to the project settings and enable the server key. So click on here, project settings, and on the cloud messaging tab, we need to enable it. It is by default disabled. So click here and click on manage API on GCP. Click on enable and wait for it to enable. Okay, it is enabled successfully. Let's refresh it to get the server key. Copy this server key and add this in Kommunicate dashboard. So here we add our new server key and click on save. Okay, now we have to create a Firebase cloud messaging service in our Android app. So let's go here and create a new class. Call it as FCM. And implement Firebase. After that, we need to implement two methods, that is on new token and on message received. So let's implement on new token. So on token, and then here we need to pass that key into our Kommunicate server. So let's import this and then add update device token and pass the context and token. So after this, we implement this on message received function. And here we can add this piece of code. Okay. After this, we can run our app again and confirm that if we get a notification or not. Now our app is launched. Let's create a new conversation. And send a message. Now head over to the dashboard and from here we can reply. So before replying, let's close the app so to get a notification. And now let's reply from the dashboard. So now in our app, we will get a notification called as FCM notification. And if we click on this, the conversation will open up. Now from here, we could chat again. And you will get a message.